writer or an artist or anything like that. But like Oprah said, I do believe that there is the greatest power in sharing our stories and telling our truths. I've never really been a person to share my personal life a lot. It makes me really nervous. But I decided that if I was going to stop being ashamed of the things that happened in my past, then I was going to have to stop treating them like a shameful thing I feel like I have to hide from everybody. So I guess the idea for this all kind of started when the Me Too movement hit social media a few months ago. All the women, the countless women who shared their stories during that time, were so inspiring to me. And I remember I was sitting in my bed at my apartment, staring at an open Facebook post, ready to type, and the cursor was just blinking back at me. And I wanted so badly to type something, to type anything, to partake in this great movement say something important, but I couldn't bring myself to do it at the time, and I kind of have regretted it ever since. So I decided to make a bold move. Well, actually, I decided a few times to make a bold move and then went back out every time a few weeks before. So I guess to get right into it then, my ex-boyfriend, Spencer, who I dated for 3 years, from my sophomore year of high school to a few months into my freshman year of college. Never called me college before. but he was pretty sexually abusive and emotionally and manipulation, but that's not the point right now. The way I always put it to anybody who I've told, which is a select few, is that what I wanted or what I was comfortable with was just wasn't really in consideration, I guess, of what was going to happen. And I can remember laying next to him in bed one time, just at his house in my hometown, and he decided to start something, and he got on top of me, and he had a good 7 inches and 150 pounds on me. He started doing whatever, and I tried to push him off. Ever was my older sister. start affecting my present today. It's funny, and people that I've talked to who have gone through similar things get the similar thing that happens to them too sometimes, where it's really hard for me to say no if I don't want to, or if it hurts, or I'm uncomfortable, or whatever. It's kind of like a stream of consciousness of thoughts in my head that I can't stop. Like just keep going, just hold on a little longer, can't last much longer. They'll be mad if you stop, they'll be mad if you stop, it's just gonna be a fight, like just hold it for a little bit longer. And the first time that happened to me and I lost and I couldn't make myself say something, I was crying after, naturally, and the person was pretty startled because they had no idea what was going on. And that person was the first person I ever actually told about anything that happened. And that was the first person who ever told me that they were sorry that that happened to me and that it wasn't my fault. Because for years and years, it was really hard for me because I was mad at myself. Because how could I be the kind of person to let that happen to me? I just let it happen to me over and over again. And how could I be so weak, and how could I be so ashamed? And there's actually a note that I wrote. My phone is like a diary. I just type thoughts as they happen to me. And there's a note that I made my freshman year of college, probably the worst mental headspace I've ever been in. And I made a list of bad things about myself. And it says, cheater, because I cheated on Spencer when I first came to college. Victim of sexual assault. Cynical, self-deprecating, procrastinator, lazy, perfectionist, health issues, poor, unlovable, too pale, disgustingly fat thighs, fucked up feet, eyebrows too thick, nose too big, lips too thin, shoulders too broad, and but through all of that, I've met so many amazing people who anyone, if I've talked to you about anything that has happened to me previous to this, you know that it's those people who changed my life and made me realize that I had to start dealing with it, and that it wasn't my fault. And like Allie Raisman said in her speech at Larry Hussar's sentencing hearing, I'm no longer a victim, I'm a survivor. And I think that I've come a long way to really stop seeing myself as all these imperfections and all these things that happened to me, and realize that, I don't know, that this is the body that took me through all of that and survived all of that and got out of that. And it's the one who graduated high school with a 4.6, and it's the one who has made friends and been in love and gotten heartbroken and done all these things, and there's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing wrong with me just because some guy took advantage of a 15-year-old girl trying to impress him. To close, we are not mindless bodies who exist just for your pleasure. We are not attacking the male gender. We are not overreacting. We are not starting to tell these stories just to get 15 minutes of fame. We are real women with names and faces and lives who trusted you. And we won't sit back and watch anymore.